Yeah. What do you mean?
I mean, do you remember what we did at this point? You know?
Yeah.
They would come on stage and they would sweat.
They'd be sweating. be swimming?
They're drenched.
They'll be drenched in sweat.
There would be sweat droplets on the floor, like driplets of sweat. And there would be puddles.
There'd just be puddles.
There would be puddles.
Yeah.
There would be one here.
Okay.
And there would be one here.
Of sweat.
Yeah.
And you, it was really wet.
Yeah.
So you sit, and you have to be careful because you might mess. So.
My king, and I thought I could trust my country, but I just don't know. do you do when the only thing you can trust is a fucking water bottle? What do you do when the only thing you can trust is a fucking water bottle?
That's it. We changed it because we didn't want to swear. So when we did it, it was with a damn water bottle. I really remember that. Sorry.
That took up most of the stage.
Do
had it imported from China. Do you remember? Do you remember that? Do you remember a table that took up most of the stage? Could you say something? Could you say something back to me?
I remember when the bodies were being dragged on the floor from over there.
We work together. We do this thing. We do this together. Do you remember a table?
Yes.
Do you remember the tape?
Yes. It was massive.
Ceiling,
let the air rush out.
All the hot air, so we'd be cold for a while and then we'd have to shut it down and heat everything up again. Every night, the same thing. Yeah?
And there was a sound. There was a sound, like
the crane? Like beep, 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 beep,
beep. Or like rain, like rain on the surface.
Like water.
Rain on
yeah.
the surface of the table, because it was winter at the time.
So sometimes it was frozen. We had to like thaw this layer of frost from the table.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or snow,
on the surface.
Or water on the surface of the table.
Seasons are changing, and it's all of these you know, washed out greens and browns and greys, and there's the kind of the spooky wind is blowing through everything, and all the creatures are huddling under leaves from the rainfall, and they're being silhouetted by lightning and thunder, and it's quite moody and scary. And I used to really love that bit. And every two or three weeks, I'd go around and cut his hair, and we'd watch that together. And then you know, you're growing up, you're changing. I must have said something or done something. We're 11 or 12 years old, and he just stops inviting me back, and now whenever I watch Bambi and it gets to that scene.
And then there's a moment of dissent at the table. And then the king gives the barber a cue, and then the barber takes out a long, sharp blade from his pocket and he slices through the necks of everyone at the table.
Do you remember Jacob? He would come in with the custard tarts.
They wanted to be a part of it because what else were they gonna do?
I mean, they could have stayed at home, or they could have just gone.
I mean, okay, if you look back, what they did was very risky, right? And all I'm saying is that maybe we should have known.
I think that's extremely convenient to say.
But isn't it obvious? Isn't it obvious to you now when you think back on that time? How clear the parallels were.
No.
Have you heard it?
Have you done this before?
Rebecca?
Yeah.
Rebecca, could you get me?
Thanks.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, let's get ready. Thank you, Holly. Good to see you.
Yeah.
No, you put that all over your head.
Can you do it?
And then you get down on your knees.
Yeah.
yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
So much pain.
Oh Christ, I can't.
I'm dying.
My hands.
I'm dying.
I'm going to die now.
Dying here alone on the battlefield where I am because
wait,
I'm
wait.
A soldier.
Yeah.
snow.
Snow doesn't make a sound.
What about when you walk in it? And you crunch it?
This moment, I'm halfway through an article about the rise of local versus migrant violence in Germany and the inevitability of a civil war. I'm partway through a University of California, San Francisco article and video recording about how brain cells migrate around the brain, hitching rides on blood vessels. I have an email open about a Barbican press ticket to see Mogwai score Atomic, an archival film about the horrors of the nuclear age. My Google calendar is open. On my Facebook, the Samuel Beckett page has shared a video of an actor talking about doing a Waiting for Godot with children. In each of these circumstances, I am in a state of anxious incompletion, a kind of mental buffering toward nothing. I am in Berlin, where they are burning migrant reception centers. I am in the metaspace of September, trading blank days for details of future commitments. I am following a line of thought that the cheap, easy way to seem progressive and creative in the theater is to suggest we do the thing, but with children. I am in a microscope watching oligodendrocyte precursors swing and jump from blood vessel to blood vessel like miniature apes. Nothing is finished, everything in flux. I yearn for clear-headedness, but more so evidently I yearn for noise. My brain is the world's landfill. It is also a concert hall, freedom parade, smut cinema. It isn't that I don't think, that I don't deconstruct what I read, that I don't mull, but I never go deep. I'm certain I remember barely a tenth of it the next day. The engine is humming. All of the engines are humming.
Shh.
you remember that? We killed someone. I mean, did someone die?
Maybe we had to kill them?
Did we kill someone that we had to kill?
Maybe we loved them.
Did we kill someone we had to kill because we loved them? Maybe we cared. Maybe it was kind. Did we kill someone as an act of kindness?
Like a mercy killing.
Right, right. Was it kind of like...
bad.
She feel too bad.
Better?
How will you love now that you're dead?
How will you cheer now that you're dead?
How will you cheer now that you're dead?
How will you know for sure now that you're dead?
How will you know for sure now that you're dead?
How
you're dead.
How will you cry now that you're dead?
How will you cry now that you're dead?
How will you walk now that you're dead?
How will you walk now that you're dead?
How will you go to the toilet?
How will you go to the toilet now that you're dead?
How will you laugh now that you're dead?
How will you laugh now that you're dead?
How will you sing?
How will you say your name now that you're dead?
How will you spend time alone now that you're dead?
Louder.
How will you be a parent now that you're dead?
How will you be a parent now that you're dead?
How do you know you're okay now that you're dead?
You don't need to be louder. You be louder.
How will you give up now that you're dead?
How will you give up now that you're dead?
Be gentler. Start again.
How will you love now that you're dead?
How will you love now that you're dead?
How will you cheer now that you're dead?
How will you cheer now that you're dead?
How will you know for sure now that you're dead?
How will you know for sure?
Stop mumbling. How will you know for sure now that you're dead?
How will you know for sure now that you're dead?
How will you understand now that you're dead?
How will you understand?
Be sadder! These are sad lines, okay? Be sadder! Yeah?
How will you pick up the phone now that you're dead?
How will you cry?
How will you cry now that you're dead?
How will you walk?
Hey! I said be sadder! Is that how you're sad?
How?
Stroke my head! Why are you laughing?
Because I'm scared.
Stop laughing! Continue.
How will you laugh now that you're dead?
How will you laugh now that you're dead?
How will you say your name
now that you're dead? How will you spend time alone now that you're dead?
Why are you rushing? Leave an appropriate amount of time between the lines. Why are you so shit? Keep going.
How will you be a parent?
Stroke her hair! Okay.
Try a different way.
Get out! Get out!
Why else have to go?
All of you, get out!
Right? So, maybe.
maybe one more, yeah. like a noise, like a sound.
A cheer.
Like a cheer.
Yeah.
A cheer.
Yeah.
Like
a cheer.
Okay, we can start from the bottom.
Yeah.
We can start about,
yeah.
And we're going to rise. We're going to rise. We're going to rise up.
I've been running through every town and village in this country, and everyone I meet has something different to say about the king. And I'm nearly there, and I don't know what to do, and I don't know who to believe, and I don't know who to trust. I can't trust my king. I can't trust the strangers I meet on the road. I can't trust myself. I don't know what to do. What do you do when the only thing you can trust is a fucking water bottle? Thank you. miss the television, the good chair. I want ice cubes from the fridge and a soft duvet. I want to be able to get drunk in my own house and be held by you. I never look at anything. It's beautiful out here. If my lungs weren't so painful, now even with the pain, the trees with the sunlight through the green chlorophyll, I should have looked at you one last time. I can hardly remember the shape of your face. Yeah, I've got that song in my head. All together now, think of wind in the trees, think of trees, leaves rustling, keep breathing, come, come.
You're talking about
about the bomb. No one's talking about the bomb. No one wants to talk about the bomb.
Why?
Exactly. Why?
Well, we've been at war for a very long time.
We've been at war for a very long time.
You come here, right?
Yeah, I'm from here.
You live in a town that's right next to the
battlefield. Exactly. Well, we're all close to it. We're all right up close to it. We're against the glass, you know. We're squeezed against the glass of the wall, but no one wants to look in our face. It could be anyone. It could be anyone. You know, it's not like they've got zippers in the back. You know.
What?
Underneath, you know, your mum could be a lizard. It could be your best friend that's a lizard. And they take. Have you seen what they do to the bodies?
I'm talking about the actual war. We've got bullets
and they've got gamma rays and they like microwave you from the inside.
No.
It's like thousands of years.
No.
It's been really nice to meet
you. Why
are
you saying that?
Very refreshing.
Hi, my name is Mal. I'm 35 years old and I work in theater. Should I come back? Would you like a drink?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you live near a wall, right? You live near a wall.
Yes.
Correct?
I live near a wall. Yes.
Like an actual wall. We are from the same country. Are you from here?
I'm not from here, but I live here now.
Okay, so you live in this town.
Yes.
Very close to an active front line, correct?
Yes. Yeah, it is.
Okay, who are we at war with?
The other country.
Okay, so you know.
Yes.
Yeah. I've just met so many different people tonight, none of whom seem to know that we've been at war for so long.
That's weird.
That's what I thought. Okay, so we've officially lost now. I know it's been a long time coming, but we have now officially lost the war. They are coming.
Okay.
And you have... Yes, the enemy are coming. You have a maximum of 2 weeks to tell everyone to get out. Or to tell people that we're actually at war. First, tell them we were at a war for a long time, and then tell them we've lost, and then tell them...
Hey, guys, did you know that we were at war and that we lost?
You don't tell them like that. You tell them the way. I don't know who has been telling them about the fireworks. That is not the sound of fireworks. That is the sound of shelling. I mean, you hear that all the time. You must hear that all the time. You know we are at war, right? Yes, we have. I work for the army, and I've just come from the front line. They are coming, and we have lost. I am serious. No, that's not fireworks.